Hi, this is Alex from Minute Earth. Russia is the biggest country in the world. China is the most populated, and the US is the richest. And then there's Morocco, which isn't exactly a global superpower. But it is one of the most important places in the world because of phosphorus. The element phosphorus is critical for civilization. Plants need it to grow, and we need plants to eat. Soil naturally contains some phosphorus that's available to plants. But every year, some of it leaves our fields through erosion, and some of it leaves when we harvest the plants that absorbed it. So we need to add more phosphorus. We add some in the form of poop from plant-munching farm animals, but there's not enough animal poop to replenish all the phosphorus we need to keep growing food for our growing population. Luckily, some rocks are really rich in phosphorus, and Morocco is home to most of them, at least the ones we can reach. The vast majority are actually sitting at the bottom of the ocean. That's because these so-called phosphate rocks formed over millions of years as ocean-dwelling microorganisms died and their phosphorus-rich bodies sank to the seafloor. This happened throughout the ocean, but the phosphorus only concentrated on the seafloor in a few special places. In these places, there were tons of microorganisms, there were no rivers, which would have diluted the phosphorus with other sediments, and there were occasional ocean currents that carried away any lighter, non-phosphorus sediments. This rare combination of conditions allowed the phosphorus-rich sediment to concentrate into phosphate rocks, and it just so happened to occur throughout the ancient ocean that covered what is now Morocco. As a result, modern Morocco has almost 3/4 of the world's accessible reserves of phosphate rock. That's an unheard-of concentration of a single major resource in one country. I mean, China has more rare earth metals than any other country, but that's only around 1/3 of the world's reserves. And Saudi Arabia and Venezuela have more oil than anyone else, but they each have less than 20% of the world's reserves. Morocco has so much of the world's accessible phosphate rock that without its reserves, humanity doesn't even have enough to last 100 years. But even if Morocco shares nicely with everyone else, humanity will only have around 300 years. Sure, 300 years is a long time from now. But we've been relying on farming to feed towns, cities, and civilizations for 10,000 years. Even if we discover another huge supply of phosphate rock, or figure out how to mine it from the seafloor, that too will eventually run out. At that point, we could wait until the phosphorus running off our fields flows into the ocean, reaches one of those special places, concentrates again into phosphate rock, and ends up above water. But that would take a few million years, and we'd go hungry long before then. So if we plan to be a food-eating civilization into the distant future, we need to use and recycle phosphorus more effectively. In other words, we've got a problem to solve. A problem with a capital P. This video was sponsored by the University of Minnesota, where students, faculty, and staff across all fields of study are working to solve the grand challenges facing society. One of these challenges is feeding the world sustainably, and part of the solution is to ensure we have enough phosphorus to grow crops. In the Department of Soil, Water, and Climate, Professor Carl Rosen and graduate student Persephone Ma are researching whether it's possible to get useful amounts of phosphorus from unexpected places, like burnt sewage, as a way to reclaim phosphorus from our own waste and put it back on our fields. Thanks, University of Minnesota.